Good morning. I can't speak right now. I've only had like this much coffee. But no, we're taking it back a little bit in prep for doing the Rogue Invitational workouts next week. So Saturdays, usually my AM PM sessions tend to be kind of smushed together a little bit. I'll still take like a 30 minute or so break in between, but it kind of turned into like a marathon session. Or over the last few weeks, that's what it's been. But today, my AM and PM session are volume wise like very short. So it's just the AM session, I've got some gymnastics for timepiece, and then my PM is one for timepiece. So that shouldn't take me all that long. Gonna get a good warm up in and everything like that. Especially with having the gymnastics and stuff, wanna make sure my shoulders are good and prepped. So I'm gonna get ready and, or just change, I've already washed the face and all that stuff. And then, yeah, we're gonna head over there. Also, I wanted to show you guys, so my brother and my sister-in-law who live in California, who you've seen on this vlog, so they have a super cute French bulldog named Reggie. And they actually, a few days ago, said they were gonna possibly foster an English bulldog, which of course I am in full support of. If you don't know, well, yeah, you've seen Lambo in some of the earlier videos. So my parents have an English bulldog named Lambo, after Lambo Field. So they just confirmed yesterday that they're going to get this cutie on Sunday. I guess they're still picking out names, but I wanted to show you guys. Just me today working out. How cute is he? Might need to make another trip out to see them, huh? Soon. I mean, I already wanted to, but now there's even more incentive. Okay, now I should actually, yeah, it's time to go to the gym. I'll see you guys. See you guys at the gym. So it's like 7:30-ish and it's already 90 degrees, I think. I think today is supposed to be high of 114, 115, so I'm glad we're working out now, not later. Also super random, but I tried this flavor. I'd never tried this brand before, but tried this flavor. Not a fan, unfortunately. So, gonna maybe give this to a friend. Okay, now we go to the gym.
Sky, only you can make me Okay, so all done with training and it's 10 o'clock. I don't think I've been done this early on a Saturday in, oh, geez, my eyelashes are out of control. Yeah, anyways, I don't think I've been done this early on a Saturday in so long, so that'll be really nice. Hurts nice now for the rest of the day. But yeah, so first, there's a tiny airport near here, so it tends to get a little loud occasionally. So first piece went well. Arms definitely pittered out a little bit faster than I thought they would on the handstand push-ups. So I opened with 10 and they felt really good, and then I got to 16 after that and I was like, oh man, these are going away a little quicker than I would have liked. Rope climbs felt a lot better. My shoelace came untied, which was a bummer, but it's okay. So that was a good one. Rested a little bit and then did that second one. Oh yeah, I don't think I ever, geez, I'm really dropping the ball today on cut, hang on. Yeah, I just remembered that I did not show you guys what my workout was. Yeah, because I usually write it down and then I show you on camera, and I didn't do that. So, first, I did a lot of shoulder lat activation, just prepping. Did some strict ring muscle ups as a skill piece, did 5 sets of 2. And then my first piece for time was 30 handstand push-ups with a 6-inch deficit, 20 bar muscle-ups, 10 rope climbs. Did that, that went well. So took a short break, did 4 rounds for time, 400 meter run, 15 GHD sit-ups, 12 pistols, 9 deadlifts at 205. That went really well. Like I was talking about, I think in my last video, or maybe it was yesterday, I'm not really sure, about how I'm trying to get better just with acclimating to doing running in workouts. Obviously I have running pieces too, but mixing running with lifting, gymnastics and all that stuff, especially in the heat, and getting used to that. So that went well. Was doing, I think I got some friends leaving. Yeah, so the running went well and feel like I held a consistent pace throughout it. Haven't done pistols in a long time, and those were, so it was fun to have those in the mix. Normally, so I'm not a huge fan of moderately heavy deadlifts in a workout. Like out of all the barbell movements, like deadlifting's just, I don't know, it's not my favorite, but just trying to get better at having a higher turnover. So I think in that workout, it was starting to really click on, because in the past, I tend to control the weight down a little bit too much, which just being under such, or I don't know, I'm just like on too much tension the entire time. So I've been working on not controlling the bar down as much, like still staying tight, obviously, like through my core, protecting my back and all that good stuff. But yeah, just so I can have a higher turnover rate on those. So. And that really was clicking today, so I was happy about that. Yeah, so now I'm just gonna walk around for a little bit, cool down, and then go home, eat. I think I gotta go to the grocery store again, because I make lists. I just forget to put things on the list that I need, and so I need frozen berries. So I'm gonna go get some of those, go home and eat, and then I don't know what I've got planned for the rest of the day. I got no plans right now, but yeah, I'll see you guys. Whoa. I'll see you guys in a little bit.
Okay, so it's a little bit later. I ate a lot of food. I'm gonna have some more coffee. Now that I've been training earlier, I usually need, unless it's, I don't know, just a running session or something like that, I need something in my system. So I'll have, like this morning, I had a piece of toast with some strawberry jam or jelly. The other day I had just like some blueberries, some strawberries, not a whole lot, but just something. And then just a little bit of coffee. And then I have, like, I finished the rest of my coffee afterwards. So that's what I'm doing now. Getting changed to go to the pool. Hopefully it's not, it's supposed to be really hot today. Hey Siri, what's the temperature outside?
It's about 106 degrees outside.
Okay, so 106. So I'm going to head to the pool. I've got my sunscreen. And of course, if you guys follow me on Instagram, you know my big hat. But I'm also gonna get some reading done. I'm all caught up with stuff for my class. But I actually, speaking of just, you know, kind of that whole very long story I told you guys about, just now being a lot more confident with school and wanting to learn more. So actually one of the things that I've been wanting to do for a long time and I finally signed up for was getting, so if you've noticed during these vlogs, a lot of it is around food. And yes, that is primarily because I just love food and I love to eat. But I'm also super passionate about nutrition and learning about nutrition and and just talking about it. I love geeking out about it. So one thing that I had wanted to do for a long time was to get my precision nutrition certification. So it is a nutrition coaching certification. I've had a lot of friends go through it, have said great things, and it's something, and it's awesome because you get to do it at your own pace. So I knew that I could do it, like right now it's great because like I, you know, don't have like a ton of schoolwork to do right now, so it's allowed me to start this up. And it's cool, it comes with a bunch of like textbook type, it's like a three part. So this is unit one, there's three units, so it comes with three of these. And then it comes with a workbook, and then also all the textbooks are also online, and then it also comes with study guides, and then you take exams online. And it's broken up, so like I said, in three parts. Starts with just talking about what makes a good coach, why they develop this program, how they develop the program, kind of tips and tricks on how to help yourself learn better, study better, and then also help other people, you know, do that. And so I almost finished with the first unit, and then the second unit is the science of nutrition, and then the third unit, it comes in like, it's really heavy, like that. Yeah, so the second one is the essentials of nutrition and coaching, and then the third one is, wait, no, my bad. No, the whole thing is the essentials of nutrition coaching, jeez. The second unit is the science of nutrition, and the third unit is working through the precision nutrition coaching process. So learning all of those things and then learning to apply it. But yeah, so I'm going to head to the pool. Probably will be in the pool most of the time because it is very warm. And then I think that's about it. I'll see you guys later. Hello again. We're just all over the place with this video. So went to the pool, which was really nice. Stayed in the pool most of the time because it was really hot. Like it's still over, yeah. Apparently it's still 105 outside. Yeah, so went to the pool. Didn't do as much reading as I thought I would do. Just was chilling and relaxing, so, but that was good. And then just hung out, actually watched Cool Runnings on Disney Plus, such a good movie. Had some dinner, had a really good trifecta meal, some pot roast, and I also made that cucumber tomato thing again. It's really good. So now I just wanted to show you guys kind of like my nighttime routine. So normally I try to stop eating around, I don't know, like 7, 7:30, and just to like let my stomach digest, and I just sleep a little bit better. If I eat right up until I go to bed, sometimes I just have a little bit harder time going to sleep. So tonight's a little bit different. I just didn't end up eating enough earlier in the day, so I'm eating it a little bit later. Or not cramming in a bunch of food, but my meals just, I had a late lunch, and then, so it was kind of a later dinner, but eating my toast right now, and then I've got some tea. Also a serious question. So I've got this toast. First of all, this is just another type of the Canyon Bakehouse bread that I've talked about before, the gluten-free one.
So normally the gluten-free breads that I've gotten are pretty small. Like the Trader Joe's gluten-free bread is really, really good, but the pieces are like this big. And so these pieces are like quite large, but they have little holes in them. So when I'm plugging this into my MacroStacks app to log my food, like I feel like I can't log like two full slices of bread. It's like 1.8. Is that silly that I actually like am thinking about that? Or I'm like, well, since there's holes in the bread, like I get more jelly because like gotta make up for the carbs that, you know, aren't in the bread anymore. or maybe it's just me, but okay, that's all. I'll see you guys later.
Okay, so had my toast, drank my tea. Now I'm getting very sleepy. I'm gonna start getting ready for bed. What I've been trying to do a much better job over the last few months is actually taking time and the appropriate like measures to actually wind down before I go to bed. Most of the time in the past, I would, you know, be on my phone up until I went to bed, be on my computer, watching a TV show, all of that stuff. And that was something that took a long time for me to want to change. For whatever reason, I was super stubborn about it, and I knew it would help if I stopped doing that. But again, for whatever reason, that was way more difficult for me than like eating better or, you know, doing other recovery things like, you know, mobility work and all that stuff. So yeah, but I was like, you know what? I have full control over this. I know it's gonna help me with sleeping better, and which will therefore help with just my energy and recovery and all that good stuff. So so what I like to do is by 9 o'clock, usually sometimes earlier, depending on if I'm just really tired, I get ready for bed, I'm in bed, and I read. So phone's away, and then I, at the most, will read for an hour. And after an hour, it's lights out. Honestly, lately, it hasn't taken an hour. Like, I usually get pretty sleepy once I start reading. So yeah, sometimes I'm reading for a whole hour, sometimes it's like 15 minutes. So, which has been cool. Like, I've also gotten to start reading a lot of, or start and finish, a lot of really good books. Recently finished Atomic Habits, which is a really, really good book. And then my coach Sam let me borrow a lot of books that he recommended, and those were really good. One in particular was Endure. That was a really, really good one. I think tonight I don't have any like new books on the docket, so I think I'm just going to finish up some of my precision nutrition reading. Yeah, if you guys have any books that you've really enjoyed and you think I might like, let me know. That would be super helpful because I would love to just get some more books on deck for me to read. So now we're gonna wash my face. Also, shout out to my little sister Caitlin for letting me copycat her blue blocker glasses. I saw her wearing them and I was like, I really like those. I'm gonna get them. Cleanse, take off. I just had some of that Bare Minerals powdered foundation, so just taking that off right now. I love this cleanser. The Skin Better Oxygen Infusion Face Wash. Also, I don't know if you can see this on camera, but oh my god, look at that tan line from my watch. Also, I tried that tanning stuff that I showed you guys in my last video. I think it worked decently well, but I definitely didn't wash, it faded now, but I definitely didn't wash my hands enough after applying it, and I woke up the next morning and my hands were orange, so that was not good. Okay, so that is it for the nighttime routine. I'm going to go read for a little bit and then hopefully fall asleep pretty quick. I think I will because I'm pretty tired. Good night, and I will
See you in the morning.
Good morning. So I'm up, getting a little bit later. Oh, clearly I'm on a hike slash walk. Starting a little bit later than I was planning on, but it was a really good morning. Got to talk to pretty much all my family, and my brother and sister-in-law. Like I was talking about, fostered a English Bulldog, and I'll show you guys more pictures after I get done. He's so cute. So currently on a little recovery walk. It's very pretty. It's pretty warm, definitely over 100, but it's kind of cloudy. Very rare for right now, I would say, but it does make for good walking weather, that's for sure. Trying out, well actually no, I've been to this trail before, I'm not trying it out for the first time, but I normally go to, you guys have seen it, the one I was walking with my sister, I normally go to that one pretty much every week. Decided that I wanted a change of scenery. So I've been to this trail a few times, but a long time ago. Actually, the first time I came to this trail was to do some mountain biking, because it's just a good biking trail for sure. And also have a scar from, if you can see that right there, that is from my last mountain biking experience. Here, I was going down like a little downhill patch and caught some loose sand and just like completely wiped out. But I was fine, just got a little cut on my knee. But yeah, so not biking today, clearly, but just gonna go on a walk, set my watch to her, set the workout thing, and just gonna walk 30 minutes out and then go 30 minutes back. So I will see you guys in a little bit. All done. Oh, that was a good walk. I'm not gonna lie, I cut it a little short because I'm getting hungry and I wanna go home and eat. But my phone, unfortunately, was overheating a bit. So usually I'll listen to a podcast or something, but it did not want to do that. So where's my phone? Yeah, so my phone lately has been just overheating a bit, which is probably not a good sign, but it's still working, so it's okay. But I wanted to show you guys. So I FaceTimed my sister-in-law, FaceTimed me this morning, because the English Bulldog that they're fostering got dropped off this morning. And so I got to meet him virtually. And where I was just taking pictures the whole time. Look at this guy. Can you see him? Oh, it's kind of bright. Kind of. I can put like pictures of him, or ask Connor to do that. Oh my God, my heart. He just reminds me of Lambo, so it is so hot. Yeah, so got to meet him and he is so adorable. I really hope that they end up adopting him and I hope I get to meet him one day. Yeah, so that was awesome. Got to catch up with the family and Reggie and him are doing well together, which is really good. So now Reggie has a little buddy. It's just so freaking cute. So I think I'm gonna wrap up this vlog here. Probably about time. This is definitely gonna be another long one. But I love that you guys love the longer vlogs. I never anticipated, you can ask my brother, we, you know, just kind of assumed they would all be pretty short and then one thing led to another. Now, you know, the last one was 40 minutes. I was like, oh my gosh, is anyone even gonna wanna watch that? But I love that you guys love it because that's what I really enjoy watching on YouTube is just the longer videos. And so it's really cool that you guys enjoy it too. I thought it was super funny the other day, my dad was telling me, cause my family watches these, which also makes me really happy. And my dad was like, he's like, yeah, now, like, you know, when your mom is like, oh, Colleen's video's up, we gotta go watch it. And my dad was like, now I gotta make sure I have, like, snacks and a drink and, like, all these things. So I'm like,
Yeah, that's true. So, yeah, if you're watching my videos, make sure you got lots of snacks, some foods, because you might be here for a while. But seriously, all the support and love and positive comments and messages that I get from you guys are seriously, like, I know I've said it before, but like, they really, really mean a lot to me, and especially on tougher, harder days, they just really pick me up. So whether it's, you know, the comments here, or like, I've gotten some really, really sweet messages on Instagram about these videos, and it makes me really, really happy. And I always share those messages with my brother, because, you know, he's making these with me, and we both have a lot of fun doing it, so I'm glad you guys enjoy it. Oh, I did want to say, so the next vlog you see will be me and George doing all of the Rogue Invitational workouts together, so, which I think is going to be really fun. Going to be 2 days, 6 events. If you watch the Rogue Invitational, it was super awesome event. Just so crazy how they were able to pull it off with it all being online. I'm excited for those events. They look really tough. But it'll be fun to do kind of like a comp simulation of some sort. So that'll be the next one. And then most likely following that is going to be like an epic like treat meal video of some sort. Because over the last like month or so, I've been really, really dialing in my nutrition. Been changing some things up a bit, which I'll have to do a whole nother video on that. But I've been really good with it and staying really consistent, and have been just not eating cookies as much and stuff, but definitely having chocolate, dark chocolate for sure. Like this past weekend, I was gonna like make a bunch of cookies, and I was like, nah, I'll hold off till next weekend, because I think especially after these events, for sure gonna want like all the treats. My guess right now is gonna be, well, you know what? We'll leave it for the video, but it's gonna be a lot of good treats, and I'm excited to share some of those treats with you guys that I don't normally really eat on a regular basis. But I'm so excited. I think that's it for this one. Again, thank you so much for watching. Thank you for all the love and support, and I will see you in the next one.